just got back from the grocery store and I thought I'd share with you a grocery haul because I feel like y'all really do enjoy these. So this is what I got.
Okay, so the first thing I got is this house smoked whole chicken. This is wonderful for putting on top of salads, in lettuce wraps, or just on its own, and you get quite a bit. It's easy to just shred it up, put it in a container, and then whenever you need a fast meal, you can reach for this. So that's the first thing I got. Next thing I got is the Brat Hand Spicy Italian Chicken Sausage. I have not had this flavor yet, but I've had the chicken, I think it's called the chicken apple sausage, and that one's really, really good. So I'm excited to try this one. The next thing I got is a meaty center bone for Gnarlston. You'll get this later. So I got him that, and then next I got these zucchini noodles. I am currently doing paleo. It's been, I want to say three or four weeks, and I've only cheated once, but I love my carbs, especially pasta. And so this is easy to make because it's already spiralized for you, and it cures my craving of wanting to have pasta. So I usually just cook this in the pan with some butter and salt and pepper, and I call it a day. Next thing I got is just some cut up watermelons. These are wonderful because they're seedless, and so Gnarls can have some too. Let's actually give him one right now. He's so excited. There you go. Alrighty, so I think he enjoyed that. Okay, so yeah, I got these watermelons for both him and I. The next thing I got is asparagus, and these have already been drizzled with olive oil, and there's garlic, salt, and pepper on it, so I can just lay these on a pan and throw them in the oven, and they'll be ready to go. Next thing I got is, oh, this is for Gnarls too. So it's this Real Pumpkin Ultra Blend from Ultra Mix, and I like to put this in his food that I give him morning and night. He has a sensitive stomach, so this helps with it a lot. And also for Gnarls, this is a Good Buddy grain-free dental chew, because if I'm eating grain-free, so is he. I'm just kidding. Next, I got this Applegate Naturals Uncured Pepperoni. If y'all have seen any of my previous grocery hauls or vlogs, I love snacking on pepperonis when I'm on paleo. They're so good, and the macros for it is unreal. So yeah, I love these, and usually I like to get either regular pepperoni or turkey pepperoni. I just alternate. The last and final thing that I got is this Yoji green tea. This is great for brewing it hot or letting it sit for a bit and then throwing it over ice, because it's been hot here in Houston lately, so this should be good. And yeah, this is my grocery haul. I hope y'all enjoyed it, and I'll check in with y'all later. And for those of y'all wondering, this is my dog, Gnarls Barkley. He is a red golden retriever, and he is one, though he's still a puppy, but yeah, he's gonna be in a lot of my videos, but he's perfect. You wanna say hi? He has his own Instagram if you want to follow it. I'll put his information for it right here. For our girlfriend's birthday, I'm going to make a quick little dinner beforehand so I'm not hungry when I go out or anything like that. So, I'll show you what I do for that. Guys, Matthew's here.
So before I decided to start cooking, I wanted to snack on one of those watermelons I got earlier. They were super, super sweet and so good. Here in the pan, I have some grass-fed ground beef cooking with some coconut oil, and I made sure to season this with some Italian seasoning and salt and pepper. So I'm just going to preheat my oven right here to 425 degrees. So the pasta sauce I decided to use is the Dave's Gourmet Roasted Garlic and Sweet Basil. So I am just going to take that pasta sauce and add it in with my ground beef. And I'm going to be sure to mix this up really, really well so all the meat is coated. And then I'm just going to grab the Italian seasoning that I seasoned my meat with earlier and add that into the sauce, as well as some crushed red peppers. So I am just going to add a lid to all of this and let this simmer. Here I'm just placing the asparagus I bought earlier, and these were already tossed with olive oil, and there's salt, pepper, and garlic on it, so I didn't have to do much seasoning. I'm just going to put this into the oven for about 15 minutes on 425. So here I'm grabbing a separate pot for the zucchini noodles, and I am going to grab some coconut oil and warm that up in the pan prior to sauteing the noodles. So these are the zucchini noodles I showed you earlier in the video, and they've already been spiralized for you, so they're super, super easy to make. All you essentially have to do is put them in a pot and saute them, which is what I'm going to do right now. This right here is black truffle butter, and if you've never had any sort of truffle, it's so delicious and it's definitely a treat. So I'm adding this to my zucchini pasta. So this right here is white truffle oil. This plus the black truffle butter gives the zucchini pasta such an elegant and wonderful taste. I was washing some blueberries, and of course I had to give a couple to Gnarlston. So I made him sit prior, but yeah, he loves blueberries, apples, pears, honestly any fruit. So my meat sauce here has been simmering for I want to say 10 to 15 minutes now, and so I'm just going to add my zucchini noodles to the meat sauce and just mix that around really well and then let that simmer for a bit longer while I wait for the asparagus to finish cooking in the oven. So I am just going to take the asparagus out of the oven. They came out smelling delicious, and they were so crisp and so green and so good. So here I'm just plating everything I've made, the zucchini noodles with the pasta sauce as well as all the asparagus. I really hope y'all all enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up and come back and see me. Bye.